Hello, curious minds. We are back with yet another video for you to quench your thirst for all things space. So buckle right in, because we are going on a flight to the stars. Before we move on, make sure to press the subscribe button, and do not forget to hit the bell icon to never miss out on any of our latest space niche videos. In this video today, we will be bringing you up to date with the recent developments in the crazy world of SpaceX. Astronomers breathed a collective sigh of relief as the James Webb Space Telescope sprung to life. Getting the $10 billion telescope up and running following its launch on Christmas Day 2021 had been a nerve-wracking affair. JWST would not fit into any modern rocket without being folded, and it had to rely on hundreds of moving parts to unfurl the full size once in space. Ultimately, those efforts were successful, and the telescope had started returning some of its first calibration images to thrilled audiences back on Earth. Yet, the experience left many astronomers wondering if there was a simpler way to build a launch telescope of this size. "We were worried about the unfolding," says John Blevins of NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center. "But with a larger rocket, you don't have to unfold in space. You can do it on the ground." As chance would have it, two such rockets are currently sitting on launch pads. Each should ultimately exceed the power of the mighty Saturn V, which sent the Apollo astronauts to the moon. The first NASA Space Launch System is ready and waiting at Kennedy Space Center in Florida for its inaugural uncrewed voyage around the moon this summer as part of the Artemis 1 mission. The opening shot in NASA's plan to return humans to the lunar surface is in the 2020s. The rocket is meant to be as reliable as possible and is therefore based in large part on legacy hardware from NASA's Space Shuttle program. But a reliance on tried and true technology could be its Achilles heel. Some estimates currently peg the SLS's cost at an eye-watering $4.1 billion per launch. Over in Texas, Starship, a similarly capable but wildly different rocket being developed by SpaceX, is also in preparation to launch on its first orbital test flight as early as May, pending regulatory approval from the Federal Aviation Administration. The cost of the SLS seems so egregious because each multi-billion dollar rocket will be discarded after a single use, its components relegated to junk on the sea floor or adrift in space. Such was the standard for most of the space age, but times have changed. Starship and its giant super-heavy booster are instead built for endurance, landing back on Earth for rapid reuse, similar to SpaceX's current fleet of Falcon rockets. Each has already dramatically lowered the cost of reaching space. As big and bold as the SLS may be, experts say it pales in comparison with what the Starship could achieve. Starship holds the promise of transforming the solar system in a way we can't really appreciate yet, says Alan Stern of the Southwest Research Institute in Texas, who helms NASA's New Horizons mission, which flew by the dwarf planet Pluto in 2015. It completely changes the game. Either rocket's shroud-like payload fairing is spacious enough to fit cargo as big or even bigger than JWST, all without the need for folding components into the world's most expensive origami. And both launches will possess such immense thrust that they can reach remote corners of the solar system on shorter timescales with larger spacecraft than smaller rockets. Starship alone, however, is designed to be refueled in space, meaning it could transport mind-bogglingly huge payloads to hard-to-reach locales such as Jupiter and Saturn, or pretty much anywhere else around the sun for that matter. In what is likely a prelude to engine installation, SpaceX has begun stress testing an upgraded Super Heavy booster prototype. Known as Super Heavy Booster 7 or B7, the prototype is the first of its kind designed to support up to 33 Raptor V2 engines, each potentially capable of producing up to 230 tons of thrust at liftoff. Even with just 20 such engines installed, Super Heavy, measuring around 69 meters tall and 9 meters wide, will be the largest and most powerful rocket stage ever tested. That potentially unprecedented power is why SpaceX has custom-built a complex structural test stand to explore Super Heavy's true performance envelope in a slightly less risky manner. In the second half of 2021, that structural test stand briefly tested an unusual half-Starship, half-Superheavy test tank with a 9-engine thrust section, and later compressed a different test tank until its reinforced steel skin buckled. In the interim, SpaceX removed its 9-ram setup and modified the stand to support 13 rams, guaranteeing that its new purpose was to test Super Heavy's new 13-engine thrust section. Prior to Booster 7, all Super Heavy prototypes have had a similar 9-engine puck and an outer ring of 20 engines that would attach directly to the rim of each booster's cylindrical body. Increasing the central engine count from 9 to 13 was already certain to up the amount of stress future Super Heavy thrust pucks would need to survive by almost 45%. But combined with Raptor V2's thrust increases, Super Heavy B7's thrust puck could actually be subjected to at least 80% more thrust at liftoff. Altogether, Super Heavy B7's 33 Raptor engines should be able to produce approximately 7,600 tons of thrust compared to Super Heavy B4's 5,400 tons. As a result, though SpaceX never did significantly test Booster 4, it's no surprise that the company chose to give Booster 7 priority as soon as it was ready. After a few false starts and at least one pneumatic proof test that likely saw Booster 7 pressurized with benign nitrogen gas, SpaceX began stress testing the upgraded Super Heavy in earnest on April 14th. First, the booster was filled about a third of the way with roughly 1,000 tons of liquid nitrogen, or a combination of liquid oxygen and LN2. Once the rocket was fully chilled, there were clear signs of some kind of added stress as large sheets of ice that had formed on the sides of B7's skin broke apart and fell off. Only ice close to Super Heavy's base was visibly disturbed, increasing the odds that the behavior was a sign of some or all of the structural test stand's hydraulic rams simulating Raptor engines. It's also possible that the stress was caused by pressurizing Super Heavy's tanks to the point that they began to appreciably deform. Though that type of testing is far harder to differentiate, without official comments, it's unfortunately impossible to know what exactly SpaceX is testing or how successful those tests are, and when the structural test stand is involved. Nonetheless, likely, Booster 7 isn't done with the stand just yet. With this, we have come to the end of our video. Congrats on having such a great attention span. Let us know how excited you are about the new ventures of SpaceX down in the comments below. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe for similar content. Until we meet next time.